Change my heart, O God, make it ever true. Change my heart, O God, may I be like you. Change my heart, O God, make it ever true. Change my heart, O God, may I be like you. May I be like
you. Good morning, everyone. My name is Jane Welch, and I am your community leader for this Mass. We welcome everyone to our celebration. Thank you for joining us. Please listen to these important guidelines. For your safety and the safety of all present, we ask that you keep your mask on with your nose and mouth covered throughout the entire Mass. There will be no contact during the sign of peace, but please acknowledge each other's presence at this celebration. At communion, you will stand in place at your pew and leave your mask on until Father Jerry and the Eucharistic minister have moved away from your pew. Remove your mask, consume the host, and replace your mask. Once you have received communion, please be seated or kneel so the ministers will know who has not received communion. After the final blessing and dismissal, for your safety and the safety of all present, we ask that you remain in your pew until you have been dismissed by an usher so that we may maintain social distancing guidelines. Thank you. Today, we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In our readings today, we hear that much is demanded of a disciple, but great are the rewards. Elisha's benefactors furnish a room for the itinerant prophet, and he goes on to make them an extraordinary promise. St. Paul tells the Romans that those baptized in Christ are baptized into his death, but we will also live with him in eternal life. Jesus tells the apostles that each must take up his cross, but they will be rewarded with everlasting life in the kingdom. Are we willing to be disciples as well? Let us take a few moments in silence to prepare our hearts and minds so that we too may be able to take up his cross. Please stand as we welcome our pastor, Father Jerry Hurley. Let us worship together in song with our opening hymn, All Are Welcome.
Let us build a house where love can dwell, and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to grace. Hear the love of Christ shall in divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
May the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to our celebration. Glad you were able to be here with us. And welcome to those of you joining us at home on live stream. And we ask the Lord as we continue to journey through this COVID and journey through the unrest in our world, to continue to bless us, forgive us, reconcile us to Himself and to one another. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone art the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
first reading is a reading from the book, the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shechem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, wherever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, we too must think of ourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. Word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning. Welcome to our celebration on this, the 13th Sunday in ordinary time. The gospel message brings us to the conclusion of St. Matthew's missionary discourse. The missionary discourse was where Jesus was instructing the apostles as he prepared to send them out to proclaim the good news and to proclaim the kingdom. Throughout the 10th chapter of St. Matthew's gospel, Jesus has been instructing the apostles on being prepared for the mission to which he is about to send them. He has outlined the challenges in this journey and the possible pitfalls they may encounter along the way, encouraging them three times, as we saw in the gospel last week, "Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. How important are those words at this particular point in time in our country? Do not be afraid. He has reminded them that many are not open to hearing his word, and they need to be prepared to meet with resistance and hostility. And now in this final portion of the 10th chapter, he instructs the apostles on the sacrifices involved in proclaiming his word and proclaiming the kingdom. He directs them on the priorities they must embrace in being his envoys. They must be ready, if need be, to sacrifice the dearest things in life. On hearing the gospel passage initially, those are very challenging words. Anyone who loves father, mother, brothers, sisters more than me, certainly challenging, but we've got to understand the whole context of it. They must be ready, indeed, to sacrifice the dearest things in life, and in certain rare circumstances, they may even have to choose between him and their relatives. It's an experience, he says, of taking up the cross and following him. How appropriate is that theme today? With the coronavirus still certainly making its way in fearful and stressful and anxiety-prone ways, and not seeing the reduction that we are praying for or seeking, and then the unrest in our country, the crosses that those things bring in our lives are significant. Taking up our cross, it's a lot of stress and a lot of worry and anxiety, and that can spill over, and it's a cross that everybody is carrying. The work of taking up the cross and following him is not for the faint of heart. It requires a complete resoluteness, as he says, a resoluteness of mind and heart on our part to follow him. He asks every follower and every would-be follower to give him a central place in our lives and in our hearts. And it's not for his sake, it's for our sake, so that we might be in communion with him, and through communion with him, we might be able to follow his plan. The taking up of the cross is very obviously an important directive, and Jesus gave us some very valuable perspective himself on what it means to carry the cross when he made his journey to Calvary. Each of us has our own cross to carry. There's no need for us to look for one. There's no need for us to create one. The crosses we have are hard enough for each one of us. But we are willing to take, but the big question is, are we willing to take up that cross and accept it as ours? Our crosses are not made of wood, but they are made up of the burdens, the worries, the problems, the illnesses, the conflict within the family that each of us has to carry, and particularly exacerbated in this time of stress and worry and anxiety for everybody. Our personal circumstances and relationships with one another create our individual crosses. God didn't land them on us. Our circumstances and our environment and family systems and our openness or our closeness create those crosses in our lives. Our relationship with him determines how we will carry the cross. The cross may also be matters that we struggle with regarding social issues of injustice, hatred, despise, class distinction, and racism in its very many forms. And the challenge that Jesus issues to each one of us is to take up that cross and carry it, to own it in our own lives. What a difference it would make, people carrying the cross and owning their own in their lives. cross we carry may not be outwardly visible to people. For many, it is a deeper inner experience, an experience of depression, despondency, or grief, people grieving over something significant. There are many forms and shapes and sizes of crosses. But whatever it is, he is asking us to carry it, and he promises us his assistance in carrying the cross. Each of us as human beings have the tendency to see our cross, our struggle as being too much, and how often we cry out, how can I possibly carry this cross? But the answer is ultimately through him, with him, and in him. The doxology that is immortalized in our liturgy. It's the only way we can carry the crosses that we struggle with. He is telling us, and that is what he is telling the disciples as he prepares to send them out into the world. Carrying your cross, and I am carrying along with you. We can spend a lot of time bemoaning the cross that we are called to carry during the course of our lives, and thus we find ourselves making very little progress. Because we are not open to making some adaptations and changes that are necessary to embrace the cross. But appreciating the fact that everybody is carrying a cross can be a very sobering and helpful thought to us. Everybody is carrying a cross. It has been said that if all of the troubles of the world were cast into one great heap, and each was asked to pick somebody else's, that we would soon realize that there are a lot of people who have much greater problems and stresses and difficulties than I myself have. And it is said that most of us, in realizing that, would go back and willingly take up our own cross and willingly address our own issues and be glad to have them back rather than the burdens that some others are attempting to handle. Key message for the first part of the gospel is the importance of placing him first. It's not a denial of family or relationships or anything like that, but putting him first, and then all of the other relationships will find value and meaning. Putting him first above all other things, above all other relationships, and only then may we really find a way to carry our cross. Embracing the cross involves a broad perspective of the many troubles and the struggles that are a part of our world, not just my own struggles. When I become more aware of what it means to carry my cross, then I am much better equipped to help somebody else in carrying their crosses. The second issue in the gospel, Jesus stresses, is the profound dignity and implications of even the smallest act of kindness toward his disciples, toward his envoys, toward all who are proclaiming good news in our world. Simple act of kindness, he says, whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward. What a small menial act, giving a cup of cold water to the one in need. Now, it's really not the cup of cold water in itself per se, it's an attitude and disposition of the heart, an openness to receiving God's message and God's messengers. The spirit in which a deed is done, and the person to whom it is done, and the circumstances can magnify a very small act and make it pretty profound in the life of another. It's not how much that we do that matters. But how much love we put into the deed, Mother Teresa used to love to say. It's not what we do, but it's how much love we put into doing that deed that makes a significant difference. The chance to give a cup of cold water can come our way several times in one day. It may be a simple act of yielding to somebody in traffic or in the store. Or it may be a pleasant greeting to somebody. Somebody who needs to hear a positive word, an uplifting word, an encouraging word. It may be a loving and respectful response to somebody who is poor, to somebody who is homeless, to somebody who is finding life difficult. Or it may simply be a smile. How enriching and hopeful and helpful a smile can be to raise up the heart of one who is struggling. And so as we look at the gospel today and the mission of being sent out, and God knows we are all sent out. We're all sent forward to be proclaimers of his good news in the world. And we see Jesus' message to the apostles in today's gospel. It's abundantly clear. We need to know not only what he says, but we need to put it into practice. Knowing it is one value. Putting it into practice is a totally different thing. Secondly, we can begin to build our lives on a firm foundation, which is the whole opening of today's gospel, the relationships with father, mother, brothers, sisters. We can build our lives on a firm foundation, which is a relationship with him, or we can build our lives on sand. And thirdly, we can choose to take up our crosses and carry them with his assistance, or we can rail against them throughout our journey in life, just complain about our plight. And finally, we can choose to act like him. In our relationships with one another, we can all choose to act like him. Or we can do it my way, in which case we will find it extremely difficult to experience his loving assistance and his saving power. This gospel summarizes his earlier teaching. Seek first the kingdom of God, and then all of these other things will be given you as well. Life of the world to come. Amen. We take the opportunity now to pray for our needs and for all of those needs of our brothers and sisters and of the whole world, trusting in the everlasting goodness of our God.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may always be willing to take up our cross and follow the Lord, no matter the cost. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those affected by global warming, those without the resources or ability to overcome the effects of natural disasters and environmental repercussions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those anticipating the birth or adoption of a child, that they may know God's blessing in welcoming a new member to their family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may grow in willingness to offer hospitality to those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in this faith community that are awaiting the reception of sacraments, our first communicants, our confirmandees, the RCIA class, may they be filled with the peace, joy, and love of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of all who died recently, especially Evan Benjamin Hedrick, grandfather of Chris Hedrick, and Thelma Davis, mother of Scarlett Larkin. May they experience his eternal peace in the kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our beloved relatives and friends who have died in the hope of rising again, especially Ben Tickner, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that the Lord bless us in our hearts and in our minds with his spirit of peace throughout these difficult and challenging times, and that he extend to us the gift of being patient and understanding in the midst of these struggles. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, we sing of your goodness as we bring these needs before you. Listen to our prayers and grant them according to your will, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread we offer you, the work of human hands that will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands that will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, who is our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of
our hands for our good, the good of all his holy church. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he has accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being called now a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people set apart, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with all of the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory as we sing.
Holy, holy,
holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all of your people. And remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now we pray for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always." Thank you, and let us be aware of that peace that he offers and extends to us, and let's acknowledge it to one another. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. You all understand the guidelines for receiving Holy Communion. You can stay in your place. We will come to you. And keep your mask on until either Joe or myself move out of the way. And then you can take off your mask, consume the host, and please place your mask back on. Thank you. And probably best to stand up, please, if you are receiving. And then we will know. Body of Christ.
Lose yourself in me, and you will find yourself. Lose yourself in me, and you will find new life. Lose yourself in me, and you will find yourself, and you will live, and you will live in my love. Unless a grain of wheat falls unto the ground, it still remains but a grain of wheat. But if it falls and dies, then it bears much fruit. So it is with those who lose themselves in me. Yourself in me, and you will find yourself. Lose yourself in me, and you will find new life. Lose yourself in me, and you will find yourself, and you. Yes, you will live in my yourself in me, and you will find yourself. Lose yourself in me, and you will find life. Lose yourself in me, and you will find yourself, and you will live. Yes, you.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Mass is ended, and we go now in peace to love and to serve God and each other. Thank you for joining us for Mass this morning, and we continue to have a manageable schedule throughout the course of the week for daily Mass. If you have an opportunity, we invite you to come join us, 7 o'clock on Monday morning, 6 o'clock in the evening on Tuesday and Thursday, and 12 noon on Wednesday, followed by Holy Hour, and Friday, 10 o'clock, followed by Holy Hour. So it's a great opportunity for us to continue to have the opportunity for Eucharist in person. And thank you for your cooperation. You've been great in helping us out and in being compliant. It's a big contrast to what is happening outside. Your compliance and your help and cooperation certainly helping us greatly. So have a wonderful Sunday afternoon. Thank you all who've joined us on live stream. Glad to have you with us. Continue to tune into our prayer and our devotion and our efforts.
Okay, if you ordered a pork butt from the Knights of Columbus, they're available now until noon today. They're also selling plate lunches to go for $10 each. Due to regulations concerning social distancing, we will not be offering children's liturgy or nursery services until further notice. And for social distancing purposes, we ask you to remain in your pew until an usher has dismissed you. Please do not congregate in the hallways after dismissal, as people will be passing through to exit. Thank you. And let's all praise him in song with our closing hymn, City of God.
Arise from your sleep, a new day is dawning for all those who weep.
The people in darkness
have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build a city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing.
For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way.
Okay.
The Lord of all kindness has called us to
Chris,
be
go ahead. Chris,
a light for his people to set their hearts free. Let us build a city of God. Tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.